your face. If I see your face in the night, oh, I will wait. If I feel your touch, if I feel your touch in the night, my life you made. Oh, my life you made. Like a bird flying seawards slowly, crossing mountains and waters wide, I will sing your song.
Your music?
Yes.
Good. Is it loud enough, do you think?
I see your face in the night. Oh, I will wait. You will always be by my side.
Thank you.
Mom, will you?
Thank you.
Take it over there and burn it.
What?
Burn it.
Upstairs, sir.
Yeah.
Fagan, serious crime squad.
Sir Charles Stafford, dead on arrival. Found by Magdalene Sheridan. She came up from the lodge when she heard the alarm.
She's in the bathroom. She a member of the family?
Friend of the family.
Who's the next of kin?
So, Sebastian. Teaches at Queen's in Belfast. There's no reply from his flat. We are trying to trace him. Miss Sheridan will identify the body.
The 1, 2, 3, turn. Hold. Right. Is this the body of the man known to you as Sir Charles Stafford?
Yes. He was like a father to me.
Jeez! Oh my God! I didn't see anything. I swear to God, I didn't see a bloody thing. Maggie.
They killed him, Abe.
What?
They shot Charles Stafford.
Oh, Christ.
You knew, that's why you ran away.
I was scared, for Christ's sake.
You were so scared you were sleeping like a baby. I feel really bad, Aiden. I think that I might just shoot you.
I don't know anything.
Who were they?
Point that at the old man's son. Point it at Sebastian Stafford and see what he says.
What are you saying?
I saw someone I used to know and he saw me. That makes me a witness. And I know he works for Michael Longley.
Who's Michael Longley?
Sebastian owes Longley money. Real money.
Why?
Why do you think?
If he was using again, I'd know.
It's okay. I'm Detective Sergeant Fagan. We met up at the house. It's all right. Okay.
What are you doing here?
Look, I'm sorry, but I need to ask you some questions.
I've been here since 87. I was living in New York. I was living rough. I had nothing. Sebastian came and they paid for my rehab. And Charles took me in.
Have you found Sebastian yet?
He's on his way.
I shouldn't drink.
How did you meet the Staffords?
I was at school with them. With Cecilia. That's Charles's daughter. She died in a car crash.
Were you alone last night? Where are you going?
Oh, I don't know where I'm going.
You know, you were pretty well known. I remember you. Do you still make your living out of music?
I make music, I don't make a living.
Excuse me. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Sebastian Stafford is here.
Oh,
painting that has ever hung here is the portrait of my mother.
And when were you last here?
Oh, about a month ago. There was a carpet.
Yes, it's been removed.
Seb.
Never seen these paintings before.
Never.
Never in my life.
Do they belong to your father, do you think?
They could, I suppose.
Where would your father keep such things as bills of sale, insurance documents?
His desk.
Wally.
Come on. Yes.
Does the dog always sleep in the kitchen?
He never sleeps in the kitchen. He always sleeps in my father's room.
How much do you owe Longley?
I don't know anyone called Longley.
Is it more or less than the value of the paintings?
You think I arranged the robbery?
Did you?
And my father's death.
Charles did something you couldn't have anticipated. He had a gun.
They didn't find a gun.
I found it next to his body when I found him. I think he had a gun because he was trying to stop them from cutting your mother's portrait.
Oh, God.
Oh, Seb, I thought you always told each other everything.
We do.
Are you using again?
No.
Seb.
I was, at Christmas.
When I was away?
Mm.
Why?
Don't know why.
Coke?
No. No, some smack.
Ugh.
But I stopped. I stopped.
But you still owe money.
Not to anyone called Longley.
As far as I understand it, Longley controls the whole of South Dublin, so indirectly or directly, you do owe him.
Maggie, I did not set up any robbery. Now, please.
How much do you owe?
60,000.
60,000?
It was 10. The rest is interest.
Did Charles know you're in debt?
Do you think my father set it up?
Agony in the Garden, a copy of a painting by Giaquinto. Drunken Silenus after Chaperon. The Massacre of the Innocents, a copy of a Poussin painting. Saint Cecilia, the Penitent Magdalene, both by Southern followers of Caravaggio. So this must be the missing work. Judith slaying Holofernes, in the manner of Ante Veduto Grammatica. You know, I'm confused. All these paintings that have been hidden away somewhere for years are suddenly, for no apparent reason, taken out of store, insured, and hung on the wall. Hardly a month later, somebody tries to steal them. You know, none of them seem to be very significant works, but even so, they've got to be worth more than they've actually been insured for.
How much were they insured for?
Only £60,000.
Can you sell the rest of the paintings?
Not really mine to sell.
Well, they will be.
I doubt it. The house has been remortgaged time and time again. It's falling apart. Father had no life insurance. If they're worth anything, they're going to pay off death duties.
Got anything else to sell?
There's some drawings I bought with the money that Grandfather gave me. No idea what they're worth. I didn't pay much for them.
Well, I've got 60 quid we can give Longley.
Don't think that's going to stop him.
Or we can take the drawings to London, get Susie to value them, and then sell them if they're worth anything.
Fagin said he wanted to question us again.
Yeah.
So how can you go to London?
Well, they won't be watching the airports.
Oh, it's all computerised, Maggie. You'll be on a computer. So will I.
Christmas.
Why have you kept this up to date?
It was the name I was born with. Maggie Sheridan isn't welcome in all the countries of the world, whereas Magdalena Krasinska has led an exemplary life.
The Countess Krasinska. You're such a snob.
When you need me, it's not my name. There's no need, baby. Feel no pain. Guess it'll be alright in the end. No, it's gonna be alright in the end, my friend. You know it's alright in the end.
Hi. Good morning.
Would like to see Susanna Peel.
May I have your name?
I'm her sister.
Would you wait upstairs, please?
Thank God. I tried to get hold of you. How's Sebastian?
No. Well, he's in trouble, Susie.
What kind of trouble?
Money. So, would you take a look at these for me?
Uh-huh. Whose are they?
Sebastian's.
Know what they're worth?
Yes.
Alex, it's Susie. Could you have a look at some drawings for me? Upstairs in my office? Well, now, if that's okay. Right. What are you doing?
I came to you for help. I don't want to be fobbed off with someone else.
Maggie, I work on old master paintings. These are drawings.
Yes, Susie, I know that.
Modern drawings? I mean, I can't tell you what they're worth. I haven't a clue.
Oh.
Basically, they're rather good fakes.
Worthless?
Well, not worth much, to be sure. Perhaps if offered to the right person, you might make 50, 60 pounds a piece. I'm sorry.
Thanks. Thanks.
Shall I get Oliver to sell them for you?
Yes, please. He's away. He's back today or tomorrow. So what kind of trouble is Sebastian in?
He owes money. We think that Charles may have arranged the robbery for the insurance.
They only got away with one painting.
Yeah.
How much was that insured for?
Well, the whole collection was insured for £60,000. This is the one they took. Judith Slaying Holofernes.
Holofernes.
In the manner of Antividuto Grammatica. Whatever that means.
The first thing I'd say is that this is an original. But it's not a Grammatica. Another painter altogether comes to mind. Now, the person who painted this and this, Artemisia Gentileschi.
You haven't heard of her?
No.
Never seen any of her paintings?
No.
Why should it surprise you that I don't happen to know the work of an obscure 17th century painter?
Maggie, this is not surprise, this is disappointment.
Why?
Oh, this is stupid. I gave you a book.
Really?
Yes, about 3 years ago.
I don't remember.
Caravaggio and His Followers by Susanna Peel.
Ah, your book.
Yes, my book.
Yeah, of course, I remember that. It was just that...
Yes, you just haven't had a chance to look at it yet.
Well, you never read my book.
I never read your book.
What are you, 12? Actually, I did read your book. I remember a lot of ghost-written gossip dimly remembered through a drink and drug-induced haze.
You liked it, then?
I did not. Though most of my friends in the sixth form found it mildly diverting. Chapter 3, Woodstock. Chapter 4, I Shag the Four Tops.
Your friends had taste, and I wrote every word.
Oh, so you chose to call me your half-sister.
Well, we did actually have separate fathers, unless you'd forgotten.
No, I haven't forgotten.
And who did I say was the love of my life?
Oh, I don't know. Dave D. Dozy. Dickie Titchin Beat.
No, you.
Liar.
Yes, you. My little flame-haired sister.
Little flame-haired half-sister.
So if this really is one of her lost works, how much do you think that will be worth?
Maggie, you don't have the painting.
200,000?
No comparable works by her have been sold at auction for a long time.
300,000?
No, look, I can't possibly make an attribution based on a poor photograph. All I can say is the work is suggestive of Artemisia Gentileschi. It could easily be a comparatively worthless copy. I cannot say
this could be worth half a million.
You don't have. I mean, it's probably been destroyed.
No, I don't think so, no.
Well, look, I have to go. I have an appointment. Ah. Find out about Artemisia.
Thank you.
Where are you staying? Make yourself at home.
Fagin's been here, asking about you and Aidan Finnegan.
Not overly chuffed that you vanished. I told him your mother was ill.
Oh, Seb.
I know, it's all I could think of. How's your Italian?
Rusty, why?
I'm writing to Antonio Causa.
Who?
I've been studying the paperwork. All the paintings belong to someone called Agostino Salerno of Naples. In early 1945, they were acquired by one Antonio Causa. My father seems to have collected the paintings over a period of years, the first in 47, the last about 10 years ago.
And there's an address in Rome.
Yeah, what have you written?
Not much so far. Just told them that father is dead, how it happened. Asking how he came by the paintings, how he came to know my father.
What makes you think that Cowles is still alive?
Charles received the last
painting in 87. Oh, it's a long shot, I know. Maybe it's not too late to get to know my father.
Well, your drawings are going to pay for my airfare home, at least.
Save you having to swim.
Oh, shit, I left the bath running. Gotta go, Seb. Bye.
Thank you. then start to play.
Our dealers do sometimes hear about stolen works and are sometimes approached about buying them.
Can't you let it be known that you're interested in buying the Glencree painting?
Maggie, all dealers are to a greater or lesser extent bent, but one must appear to be beyond reproach. Reputation's everything.
Don't you know any utterly bent dealers?
Yeah, of course. But I can't ask them about stolen works without appearing utterly bent myself.
I could approach them.
You can't go up to people and start talking about stolen paintings. They take offence.
I could say I was a dealer.
They wouldn't believe you.
Why not?
I don't know anything about art.
Oh, I went to art school.
Uh-huh. 2 years at Chelsea, staring at middle-aged nudes and singing in a blues band does not constitute a background in fine art. Uh-huh. Choose a gallery. Choose a room. Pick a painting. Who's it by?
Sir Joshua Gainsborough.
Thomas Gainsborough, yes. Title?
I don't know.
It's from Mrs. Andrews. When was it painted?
1750? Okay, Oliver, what are you trying to prove?
Years of study and experience provide one with the foundations of any discussion. It would be like me imagining I could stand up in front of a rock band and sing.
Which is exactly what you did do on your 40th birthday.
Yeah. I was crap. Well, don't disagree, will you?
No. That's fair.
So what makes you think you can convince anybody that you were an art dealer? What do you see when you look at this picture? All right, well, it's a wedding portrait. It's late summer. Robert Andrews stands ready to reap his harvest. The saplings denote the hope of issue. The dead pheasant and his wife's lap a discreet erotic allusion.
I don't see a dead peasant in his wife's lap.
No, you see, art dealers don't make jokes.
But that's so discreet, it's invisible.
Well, Gainsborough was always reluctant to finish his work, it's true, but...
man after my own
heart. He was,
heart.
I think, quite brilliant. See, the estate takes up more than half the canvas, more than the portrait itself. No English painter before had ever allocated space in that
way. They're showing off. They're saying, look, all this lovely land is ours. Well, that's what makes it brilliant. He's got their smugness, has he? He's all there in that fancy bench. He's got his gun, he's got his dog, now he's bagged her as another possession.
Well.
But is she going to give him pleasure? No. Old Josh Gainsborough obviously didn't think so.
You see, calling him old Josh Gainsborough rather gives the game away.
You see, he put that dead thing between her legs and then even lost interest in finishing that. It's all right, Oliver. I can be an eccentric.
Oh, you could be an imposter.
I got the name and the passport. What more do I need?
New address, good Mercedes, Montblanc pen, Cartier watch. Where do you buy your clothes?
Oxfam.
Exactly. Have you had all those things? You'd still need to be seen to be buying paintings, and that needs money.
Well, you got money?
I don't have any money. No, really, look, I don't have any money.
Yes, and you live in such a horrible little hovel of a house, don't you?
I said I didn't have any money. I didn't say I didn't have a spectacular mortgage. A lot of what I do is on commission. You know, I advise buyers, I bid for them. Occasionally, I buy something for myself to sell on.
When's the next auction?
Bellamy's, New York.
Listen, you lend me the money I need to set myself up as a dealer. I attend the auction as the Countess Krasinska. I bid on your behalf, I acquire a number of works, I am noticed.
Right.
I then let it be known that I'm interested in the Glencree painting. I get it back, Susie authenticates it, and we sell it for £1 million, and everyone lives happily ever after.
How are you going to pay for it?
Cross that bridge when we come to it.
Less of a bridge, more a yawning chasm. What's in it for me? How grateful would you be?
Not that grateful.
I recall that you were not ungrateful at my 40th birthday party.
Really? I don't remember anything.
I'm going to make a few phone calls. Pay the bill.
Mr. Bentham?
Hello.
Yep.
Who is it?
Geoffrey, hello, yes.
Yes.
Oliver, who is it?
Yes, really. Yes, absolutely. Done. Bye-bye.
Do you often do that? That's repulsive.
The word is, it's in London.
How'd you get here?
Oh, I don't know. How do paintings get smuggled in, rolled up and stashed under the floor of a big lorry? Painted over and called Untitled Piece One?
Well, Oliver, have we got a deal?
25% of any sales Sebastian might make.
10.
20.
10.
Deal. Oh, darling, you're a dealer in fine art, not horses.
You talk to Susie. Has she been giving you drugs?
No, she's not the same Susie, she's changed.
Oh, Oliver, she has charm. She has always had charm. Clearly she has charmed you this evening. And you've succumbed like many men before you.
Yeah, that's why I think she should do it. Roland Savory's asked me to bid for a Goya and a de Kerny. She caused quite a stir bidding for either of those.
Let me understand this. You are prepared to risk your reputation and our livelihood by allowing Maggie to walk into Bellamy's New York pretending to be a Polish dealer and play with £1 million of Roland Savory's money.
Listen, if this is an unknown Artemisia that you've discovered, that you authenticate, that you research and write about and include in your book, you'll be up there in the front rank, an acknowledged
what
expert.
What makes you think I want to be up there in your front rank?
Oh, come on, of course you do.
Thank you, darling. Darling, you do know that I find Oliver physically repellent, don't you?
Yes, of course I do. So do I. Mostly. Oh, he's bending over so far backwards, he's in danger of slipping a disc. With me, he's sarcastic, overworked, tired. With you, he's all eager charm. It's making me nervous.
Yeah, well, I've made a novel suggestion, that's all.
Maggie, art thieves are no different from any other thieves. They're not connoisseurs or collectors. They're violent lowlives.
I can handle violent lowlives. I mean, I was married to one.
He never killed anyone.
Not that we know.
Maggie, this is my world. I'm serious about it.
Yes, I know.
I know you look at my house and my job and you think I've got it made, but I've worked hard for everything I've got. I mean, this sale in New York will be taken by Henry Fellows. He's got a title, a country pile, a network of grand relations, and he's 32. I'm 40 and a schoolmaster's daughter. I wait in line.
42? Susie, when I was in New York, I was finished. If Seb hadn't come to get me, I would be dead by now. His father gave me a home where no one else would have me, including you, and I don't blame you because I was low-life scum. But Charles took me in. He died in my arms, Susie. I prayed for the first time since school, but it was too late. Well, it's not too late for Seb. I owe him. I have to help him.
I know you do.
Seb,
You still there?
Yeah. I found a projector and some cine film. The sum that he took during the war. A vast depository of hidden art stashed away to avoid Nazi looting.
What?
It seems that Charles was...
in Italy during the war. Part of a group who tried to stop the destruction of historic buildings, works of art. Perhaps Dad met Kauser then. There's loads of letters and diaries too. I'm wading my way through them.
Seb, shall I come home?
Oh, no. Contessa is going to get the painting back.
I'm going to try.
There's other film, too.
Film with the family. You know, we went to the same hotel in Port Salon every year. Ballymastocker Bay. I don't know why. Every year we had races along the beach. One year I beat him and we stopped race.
Seb, you're right.
Yeah, I'm fine. Doors are locked. Charles's pistol is in my pocket.
Okay, well, phone me anytime.
Good night.
Gitanas, 1 o'clock. Look the business. Help yourself to anything you need, though not perhaps the stereo speakers this time.
The beautiful and the innocent.
years go by, but we don't get any wiser.
I told you, Oliver, she's always late. Always. Wait. I'll have to go.
We haven't had your lunch yet.
Well, I've had 4 chunks of bread and 1/2 a pound of olives.
What do you think?
I think I've got to go. I'll have an arugula and parmesan salad, please. It's Cartier. If you look closely, you can see it says Fartier. 10 quid. You look great. Well done.
Your London apartment. It's not Mayfair, but it's only a 3 quid taxi ride away.
Whose is it?
Oh, it's an old school chum of mine lent it to me. It's, he's been away for 3 years. He's based in Japan. He's never even lived in it.
Oh, I see.
No, you don't. It's strictly business. Carpets, no smoking.
The Assyrian general Holofernes at last laid siege to the Israelite town of Bethuli. The inhabitants were on the point of surrender when Judith, a rich widow, volunteered to save them. She dressed in her finest clothes and jewelry and went to the enemy camp. Smitten by her beauty, Holofernes invites Judith to dine with him. She goes to his tent. He wants her, desperately, but he's drunk more wine than he's ever drunk in his life. So he falls asleep instead.
Here he is, stretched out on his bed. Judith stands over him, weeping. O Lord God of Israel, give me strength and look in this hour upon the work of my hands. She takes his sword, holds him fast by the hair of the head, and strikes. She gives the head to her maid, who places it in her food bag, and together they leave the camp. The Assyrians are easily defeated. There were many followers of Caravaggio. But only one was a woman. Artemisia Gentileschi. Artemisia Gentileschi was herself raped by 2 men, Agostino Tassi and Cosimo Corley. She was 19. Her reputation was destroyed. She was left with nothing but her talent as a painter. So, why has this painting been so unpopular?
Is it because it terrifies men? She's a fully sexed, mature woman who is neither Madonna nor whore. Temptress becomes executioner. Bearer of life becomes the taker of life. A beauty made captive her soul. The sword passed through his neck.
The attribution to Antiveduto Grammatica was made by Professor Giulina Ferrari in 1921, but Professor Ferrari is no longer considered reliable, and look. An engraving made by Marco Lastri of a Judith slaying Holofernese by Artemisia Gentileschi. It is neither the Uffizi Judith nor the Naples Judith. It is a Glen Cree Judith.
Do I go to New York?
I want it back.
Love the way you play. Love the sound you make. You used to play from the heart. Now you sold out.
Very nice.
I like it.
I've got you a catalogue, and I've reserved you a seat. You should get along to view this afternoon. Right, lot 35. A panoramic landscape by Philip de Kerning. You can bid up to $1,500,000 for this one. What is it?
You've got to have some sort of code. You can't simply put your bid in your catalogue.
Why?
Well, think of it like a poker game. You keep your cards close to your chest.
Now, that's what I'm authorised to bid. If you go over by even a single dollar, my buyer is not obliged to pay, and I will disembowel myself on the auction room floor. D'accordo.
Naturalmente.
Lot 41.
41. Countess of Sussex?
This is for me. Bellamy's clearly don't think it's sufficiently distinguished to be by Van Dyck. I'm not so sure.
It's quite badly obscured by the shite of ages, but the overpainting in these areas is relatively recent. That could be to hide damage, or it could be that something rather tasty lurks beneath. Be seen to check the back of the canvas. It's been relined, not unusual for a painting of this age. Bid up to 10,000. No, 11.
13.
11. Lot 80.
The Goya. Bullfight.
Ooh, charming.
You can bid up to 3,800,000. That's 3,800,000 US dollars.
Yes. What do you get out of all this?
1%, about £25,000 if we get it, nothing if we don't.
Daylight robbery.
Not at all. Money for years of education and experience.
Okay, register at the desk when you arrive. The sale starts at 10:15. Do not be late. Don't look round. Everything serious, unostentatious. We meet up at the end to organise payments. Questions?
Nope.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Do you like this painting?
Yes. Do you find that strange?
Will you be attending the sale?
Yes, I think so. Thank you.
Holly? 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 Thank you.
I?
Uptown.
Uptown. Oh. Oh, Christ!
Countess Kasrinch.
It's a long story. I'm gonna go. Thanks for having me. Twice. When you wake up in my bed, you're pretty again. You look so good. When you pull on your fancy clothes, walk down the street, you look so good. You look so me, baby.
Advance. $820 on the telephone again against the room at $820,000. On the telephone at 800, $850 at the back. $870,000 on my left. $900,000 at the back. $920,000 on the telephone. Susie's bid at $920,000 going on. Selling at $920,000. Lot 41. Studio of Sir Anthony Van Dyke. I'm opening the bidding at $5,000. $5,000. $5,500. $6,000. $6,500. On my left at $6,500, any advance? $7,000. $7,000. $7,000, any advance? Selling then at $7,000. At $7,000, $7,500. With you, madam, at $7,500. On my right, at $7,500. 8,000. 8,500. 9,000. 9,500. 10,000. 10,500. 11,000. With you, sir, at $11,000. 11,500, madam. With you, madam, at 11,500. 12,000. 30,000. 14,000, 15,000, 16,000, 17,000, 18,000, 19,000, and I bid $20,000. $21,000, $22,000, $23,000, $24,000, $25,000, $30,000. Do I hear 30? $30,000 against you, sir, at $30,000. Going on? $35,000. Do I hear 40? This bid is with you, sir, at $35,000. Madam, going on? Sure. All done, then, at $35,000? Selling at $35,000, selling on my left at $35,000, $40,000. Any more? Sure. Selling at $40,000, $40,000. Madam, 261. Lot 42. Unattributed Venetian waterscape, opening the bidding at $3,000. $3,000. 3,500. 4,000. 4,500.
It was mine. The $7,000 and this stupid cow bits against me. How in God's name does she think she's doing?
This was your idea, Oliver.
Thank you for your support. Oh. If she goes over on the Goya, I'm finished. Seriously, I'm dead. Dead in the water. Finished as a dealer. We've got to stop her bidding.
How?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I'll set fire to myself.
$2,500,000 on the telephone, $2.5 million against the room. At $2.5 million, do I hear 2.6? Thank you, sir. $2,600,000 at the back. $2,700,000 on my left. 2,000,008. 3,000,000 on the telephone. 3,000,000 on the telephone against the room at $3,000,000. New bidder at 3.2 million on my left. 3.4 million on my right. 3.6 million anymore.
3.7.
3.8, I'm asking for 3.8. Against you, sir, at 3.8 million. Do I have four? Sure. $4 million. Selling then at $3,800,000. $3,800,000. Madam, 261? 261. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our sale for today. Thank you all very much indeed.
Hello again.
Magdalena Krasinska.
Robert Assi. Congratulations. Shall we meet for lunch?
That would be very nice.
I think it's rather an interesting piece. Should clean up quite nicely.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about? You know nothing about art.
I don't think it's significant that Roberto Tassi was bidding for it.
Tassi was bidding for the pleasure of seeing Countess Polska make an arsewife of herself.
Excuse me. Countess Polska did actually get you a Goya.
$40,000 for a studio work.
I'm having lunch.
Who with? Joshua Gainsborough?
Roberto Tassi.
What?
Maggie, I don't think that's a very good idea. Tassi is the New York dealer. He knows everything about everything.
That's why I'm having lunch with him.
Could somebody do me up, please? So he can spread the word.
And what word's that, fake? He'll suss you in 2 minutes.
He's going to assume that you know the Countess of Sussex is by Van Dyke, and you don't know anything about Van Dyke.
Yes, I do. I thought he was very good in Mary Poppins.
Maggie!
Don't worry, darlings. Everything will be fine.
You know, the Italian dealers already have a name for you. La Pittura.
Then they are very foolish.
They are just curious. No one knows who you are, where you've been until now. In Poland, perhaps?
Not so much.
I've been too inquisitive.
Was it good for you, the sale?
Yes, quite good. I didn't think you would bid so much. I thought I would win the Countess.
But you lost.
I regret that. Once I brought some tomato seeds from Italy, planted them here in New York.
And did they grow?
Yes. They looked beautiful, but they had no flavor. I should have brought some Vesuvian soil as well. Sometimes things are not what they seem. I'll give you $100,000 for the Countess.
Thank you, but no.
$150,000.
You know, I was brought up to believe that it was very vulgar to talk of money in public.
Yes, it is.
So, I will take the Countess back to London and I will have her cleaned.
Most of the good places have gone. Except this one. You will not find better food here in New York. Signor Scardone, mi ha preparato il solito posto su?
Sì, signor Tassi.
Ho già scelto il vino. Come. Big line of fish in from Italy, fresh every day.
Flying fish.
Seb, you all right?
No, I've been trying to get hold of you. Where have you been?
What's the matter?
The dog is dead.
Oh, Seb.
She disappeared yesterday. I found her down near the lodge.
Oh, darling, well... She was old, I suppose.
No. It was lonely.
Oh, God. Look, I'm coming home today.
To Ireland?
No, to London. You come to London. I'll look after you.
Shall I?
Yes. Come to London. Oh, sorry, I'm so tired.
You paid for it in New York.
Oh, I tell you, you paid so much for it, we can't afford to restore it.
Yeah.
It was catalogued as the studio of Van Dyck. The Countess thinks differently. This whole area here has been overpainted, probably earlier this century. Maybe to make it thinner. This area here, which is by a different hand, this could be as early as the 17th century. Shall I do a test?
Absolutely. Is your father in?
He's upstairs.
Mr. Bentham.
My father's Mr. Bentham. I'm Jeff.
Jeff. My speciality are the Neapolitan Seicento paintings, particularly the work of Antiveduta Grammatica.
Each to his own.
Excuse me?
I prefer landscapes. Something watery. Cows in a water meadow.
Yes. I am interested in acquiring the Glen Grey painting. I understand it is in London and it is for sale. I was rather hoping that you might help me acquire it.
Here, take a look.
Ah.
I'll see what I can do.
Did you buy it?
Yes, I think so. So what happens now?
We wait.
Stay here?
I can't be seen with you, you know. That would ruin everything.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you stay with Oliver and Susie?
Yeah.
I know they'd love to have you.
Okay. Do you have any money?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I do. Do you want me to call Susie for you?
No. All right.
Call me in the morning.
Bye.
Great to see you, Seb.
Finally become the snob you always wanted to be. You, a robot, is just a robot. You don't know them. You haven't worked with them. They're a cleaner, better breed than we are.
Excuse me?
I, robot. When the Earth is ruled by master machines, and robots are more human than mankind.
I just picked this up this afternoon, one of those second-hand bookshops. You know it?
No. I was just reading the back cover.
Hello? Yes, this is Magdalena Krasinska. Yes, I can. Where? And what time? I'll be there. No, that is too much. No, I will pay you $250 up front and then $250 if he shows. Yes, I will see you there. Thank you. It's Maggie. Jeff Bentham's come through with a meeting. It's at the Marquis in Shepherd's Bush. But there's no time now, Oliver. No, I'm on my way there now. It's worked, Ollie. I'm going to get the painting.
No, don't.
Who's that? Oliver, what's going on?
Where is she? Where is my sister?
Barman, hello. Stolichnaya.
What?
Vodka. You have vodka?
Yes.
Is it cold?
No. But we have ice.
Don't think so.
Any cab for Krasinska?
Yes.
We're closed.
The woman that was here.
We're closed.
Where is she, please?
Let go of my arm.
Where is she?
Let go of my arm, or I'll break your friggin' neck.
And that's where I was told. I can take you home if you like.
No. How much do I owe you?
That's already been sorted.
Magdalena Krajin.